Hi, gang. You're just in time for another meeting in King's Clubhouse with Stan Boresson and all the gang. Today, we've got some dandy cartoons. It's zoo day. The old-timer's going to be on hand. And I think Stan is doing all of his spring cleaning today. Anyway, there's a lot of activity around the clubhouse, so come on in and find a seat and get ready to sing the theme song.
Hi there, gang. Well, it really rained last night and pretty wet in the clubhouse here. I've been putting pans around and trying to get the place cleaned up, but I'm not getting any cooperation. All Herman wants to do is dance, and Nomo just wants to rest, and it's terrible. Well, let's sing the theme song. We'll see what we can get done here.
Zero doctors, mucho cross, cause hallabaloo's a bub. That's the secret password that we can get in the club. And zero doctors, mucho cross, cause hallabaloo's a band. Means now you are a member of King's TV Club. Stan and Nomo and Herman.
Herman, I'm going to really need some cooperation now because Nick is coming down here after a while and I want everything to be all spick and span. This is spring cleaning in the clubhouse. Old-timer, are you here too?
Mr. Barnbert, what is this you're talking about they won't help you with?
No, I'm trying to do my spring cleaning here and nobody wants to cooperate. Noma wants to sleep and Herman wants to dance. And nobody's doing anything and it's all left up to me.
I'll help you. I'll do. Just a minute. Here, take my cleaning up cloth and get some water on it and get it to me in here and I'll help you with this spring cleaning.
Old-timer.
You bring the spring over here and I'll clean it there.
All right. Know something?
What?
I'm glad you dropped in.
Why is it?
I've written a special tune all about you.
For me?
Sort of in honor of when you drop into the clubhouse.
Let's hear it.
Who lives in the closet and don't pay no rent? Everyone knows the old-timer. Who has a horse with a back bowed and bent? Everyone knows the old-timer. Who's been every place, done everything, goes uranium prospecting every spring. Who thinks my name's Mr. Borenberg? Everyone knows the old-timer.
Well, ain't it Mr. Borenberg?
Nope. Who tells fabulous stories so hard to believe? Everyone knows the old-timer. Who's got many a trick left up his sleeve.
Yeah.
Everyone knows the old-timer. He's terribly bashful, we all agree. He won't show his face to you or to me. Who do we hear from but never see? Everyone knows the old-timer. Who brings many a chuckle to you and to me. Everyone knows the old-timer.
Oh, Mr. Barnberg, you know, I feel like one of them celebrities now that I had a song read about me.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
See, we're going to have two brand new cartoons today, too. And now, if you'll help me, you know where we really need work is up along cleaning out the gutters and things around the side.
Oh, well, I'll...
And I want to get everything cleaned up on the roof, too, as well as the inside before Nick gets here, so it'll be nice and, you know...
Yeah, well, I'll get a bucket and get on up there through this trap door in here.
Yeah, we'll get all your equipment together.
I'll
get a rope, you know, to tie around your waist and the ladder and everything. And
I'll get all ready here.
I'll mosey all over through here. Yeah. See if I can press the buttons for the cartoon.
I'll get the rummaging in here and
get all the cleaning right out and everything. And we'll get her cleaned up today. Here we go.
Clean up from our
Hey,
what?
Old bathroom, why can't you stood still? I can't paint your picture when you're yomping around.
Well, what are you going to do with that?
That's for your mouth.
You're going to paint my mouth with that?
No, I'm going to stuff that in your mouth if you don't shut up.
Oh.
Stood still, Lerna.
Is it coming along now pretty good?
It's beginning to come along, but I'm having a little trouble with your ears.
Your what?
I said I'm having a little trouble with your ears.
What did you say?
I'm having a little trouble with your ears.
Oh, that's funny thing. I'm having a little trouble with my ears.
Yeah.
I can hardly hear what you're saying over there.
Oh, ye bitch.
Yeah. How's it coming now? I'm getting kind of nervous.
Well, I'm having a little trouble with your nose.
What's the matter with my nose?
I don't know. It smells.
My nose smells?
Yeah.
Well, naturally, my nose smells. What else am I going to do with it?
Ye bitch.
What?
How did I get your mouth up on your forehead there?
What? My mouth on my forehead?
Get my mouth off my forehead.
The chin. The chin. It just isn't right.
The chin isn't right?
The chin just isn't right.
What's wrong with the chin?
It isn't right.
What's wrong with it?
It just, I don't know. I can't find it.
You can't find my chin? This picture's gonna be a mess.
Oh, no, this picture is very lifelike. This picture, when I get through with it, which I am almost...
Oh.
Why, you would be able to almost walk up and shake hands with it if
no.
It would be so lifelike.
Isn't that gonna be wonderful?
It might even wink at you. It's so lifelike.
Can I see it now?
Wonderful picture.
Am I ready?
Wait a minute.
I get so nervous. Am I ready?
You're ready. The master push is done.
It's a real master push?
Yeah.
Oh, let me come over and take a squint here.
Look at that. Look at that.
Wait a minute.
Isn't it lifelike?
Well, it is pretty lifelike. What? Foghorn.
Don't you think that's got movement?
Does it have movement?
And color and movement. Imagination.
What is that under my nose?
And movement. And,
what do you got under my nose?
And movement. Don't you think that's the most beautiful picture? Hasn't it got fire and movement? It's got, didn't I told you it's got movement?
Yeah, this painting has really got movement.
Yeah.
And boy, you never saw such movement as this.
You like that?
Yeah, though. Now you're gonna really see some movement here.
Yes.
There's movement.
Oh dear. That hurt. Roll the film.
Hello everybody out there in television land. Well, it's a real extremely pleasure to be here with my famous program, The Swedish Answer Man, answering all the problems with what? Thank you for the makeup. My first question, coming in here from Axel Grease of Bering, Indiana. If you can bear with me for a minute here, it says, can you tell me who started the war in 1812? Yes, I can. It was the fellow in 1813. And here, why was Benjamin Franklin out in the rain flying his kite? Well, Benjamin Franklin was out in the rain flying his kite because his wife took away his rubber duck. Come back here. All right. And it goes on here. So foggy in the studio today. How can you tell if a pearl is cultivated? No. How can you tell if a pearl is cultured? Well, I tell you, if you can tell if a pearl is cultured, you take her out to dinner, and if she slurps her soup, drop her like a hot spot and start taking out Mabel. Here coming in the question. From Greg Arias. Greg Arias. Of Obnoxious, Alabama. In our 4-H class, we are studying farm animals. Can you tell me one of the byproducts of cattle raising? Yes. One of the byproducts of cattle raising is calves. Here comes one from Oscar Reiser of Mixed Up, Minnesota. He goes on, I am very interested in nature. Can you tell me the four seasons? I will be most happiness to do this. The four seasons are salt, pepper, mustard, and vinegar. What kind of fool are you and me to get that? Here he is. Here comes one from Lem Meowth of Alcatraz, California. The houses of Sweden are built of wood, and those in England are built of stone. Can you tell me what the majority of the homes in France are made of? Yes, the majority of the homes in France are made of plaster of Paris. Oh, isn't that beauteous? How much time have I got left? I search for you. We have one more question. My cat, oh, this comes from May Basket of Springfield, Illinois. My cat insists on sucking lemons. What will happen to her? Oh, this is very serious. If your cat is sucking lemons, she will undoubtedly turn into a sour puss. And thank you, everyone, for tuning in today. And here's something just wonderful coming up on the same network.
Well, I don't know if I'll know the words to this, but I'll get it.
Well, I think you'll catch on.
I'll start it off.
Not very fast, mate. Why don't you?
All right.
You'll catch on quicker that way if you start it off.
Why don't I count to three again?
Why don't you count to five and I'll put my mustache back?
Yeah.
How come you always count to three when this is four times?
Well, I tell you. Oh, that's just to get everybody set, you know.
Go ahead. Count to one and a half by twos.
All right, let's count to three.
All right.
One, two, three.
When the vast was young, there was a lot of reckless young kids what got into terrible trouble. And this here is a song about a story about a young kid what got into terrible trouble. He was a high school dropout.
Then Jesse James was a kid, he must have flipped his lid, 'cause he robbed the Oslo train. And the people off repeat, he was full of aquavit, and that stuff make you do things that are strange. Yes, he was a jerk who never did no work, he was a dirty crook, and he's better off dead than lying around in bed. At least that's what it says here in the book. It was on Lurdog's Grell, we remember it so well, then they robbed the Oslo train. But the engineer named Knut, he didn't give a toot, told Jesse, next time take the plane. Oh, yes, he was a thief, living on relief, but a crazy nut. And he was always wishing that he could go out fishing, if only for the halibut. Play a little instrumental there and make him forget what we used to have.
Oh, my fingers are so stiff.
Well, I thought he was playing with your foot. So.
Now let's sing a little bit and make him forget what we used to play it. He robbed from the poor and he gave to the rich, how much he never knew. And like all other crooks who don't keep no books, he was caught by Internal Revenue. For yes, he was a slob who didn't have no job, he was a terrible creep. But he was creepy once too often, and now he's in his coffin, buried 6 foot deep.
Hello, Sheldon.
This is your Uncle Torvald with a lovely bedtime story for you before you hit the sack. Go to bed. And the name of this beautiful story is Little Red Riding Hood. Don't stop me if you've heard it, because this is the one I'm going to tell anyway. Come on over close and away we go. Once upon a quite a while ago, so back far I couldn't remember so pretty good, there was a little girl, and she had a name which was called Little Red Riding Hood. Well, this little tomato was a pretty cute chick, I'll tell you that. And one day her mama said to her Hood, she always called her Hood. She says, Hood, I want you should take these 2 old loaves of bread over to your fresh grandma where she lives over in that house, over that place where she's boarding over there, that place. And Little Red Riding Hood said, sure you bet your boots, I will do that for you. And her mama said, Hood, you are such a good, kind, wonderful, obedient child, sometimes I think I'm going to blow my top. So Little Red Riding Hood took the 2 loaves of bread and started out for her grandmother's house. Well, it was springtime, and the flowers was flowering, and the buds was budding, and the bees was being. And oh, it was just such a wonderful day that Little Red Riding Hood couldn't help stopping to smell of all the flowers. You know, roses, asses, spatunias, galdarnias, narcissodendrons, all those. Well, Lily Hood was just smelling to beat the dickens for a while. And pretty soon it got late and she stopped smelling and started into hurry. Well, pretty quick she came up to the edge of the Seattle-Tacoma Freeway, and a great big shiny red convertible automobile came down the road and stopped with the yerk. And the yerk leaned out and he said, hello there, cutie puss. You look like a pretty slick chick to me. Could I take you someplace? Well, Little Hood was no square. She knew this guy was the wolf. She'd read the story before, you see. And she said, no, be on your way, Junior. You got the real crazy set of wheels, but man, I dig you the least. So blow, Snow. And he did. And he did. And later she married a fella from Mukilteo with a Model T Ford. And they lived happily even after. But you know something, Sheldon? I often wonder what in the world could have happened to Grandma and those 2 old loaves of bread. Good night, children.
We're out here at Hardtack Airport waiting for the Stockholm chairman of the Tomatoes for Torvald to arrive. Oh, you know, this politics gang is exciting. And she's coming in from Stockholm any minute, letting me know how the campaign is coming along. Because we all got to get together and get Torvald elected for senator. Oh, I think she's coming.
Torvald for president.
President?
Torvald for senator.
That's more. Why, it's Grandma Torvald.
Hello there.
Oh, Grandma.
Yeah.
I didn't realize. Are you the chairman? Are you the chairman for the tomatoes for Torvald?
I'm the head tomato.
Oh, from Stockholm.
Yes, and here I am.
Oh, well, I'm so anxious to ask you things about the campaign.
Will you ask me things about the campaign?
Yes. Would you say running for...
Stop. I don't run for anything at my age. I walk very slowly. Change that
sentence. Well, would you say walking for a public office is difficult?
All right. Walking for a public office is difficult. But it doesn't make sense that day.
Yeah,
no.
No, it doesn't make sense. Now, could you tell us about... You don't think they're trying to get rid of us, do you? Watch those high or low flyers there. My goodness, that's terrible.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Now, we're not sure of Uncle Torvald's political affiliation. Tell me, is he a Democrat or a Republican?
No, he's Swedish, is what he is. On his mother's and his father's side.
I see.
Swedish.
Now, what does he stand for?
Well... He stands when ladies come into the room, and when he gets on the bus and nobody gives him a seat, and then the flag goes by.
Yeah. Well, you know, we've heard much talk about the platform committee.
Yeah.
Could you tell us about Uncle Torvald's platform?
Well, he doesn't have a platform.
Yeah.
But he has a large bay window we're all quite concerned about, you know, cholesterol and stuff like that.
Oh, that's a shame. He's, the image is wrong there.
Yes, it is. I'm going to put him on a diet.
Now, we've heard a lot of talk these past few weeks about conservatism.
We have, yes.
Yes, and progressivism.
That's what
we And have. Liberalism.
Yes.
Now, would you say Uncle Torvald is a moderate, or a liberal, or a conservative, or a moderate progressive? Just what is Uncle Torvald?
Uncle Torvald is impossible until he has his first cup of coffee in the morning.
Oh, here they come again. Wow.
That's a chopper that time.
I beg your pardon? Something the matter with your chopper?
No, there you are. Go on with my interview,
yeah.
Quickly.
I want to know. Don't drop your pictures.
No.
The frames are very expensive.
Aren't they nice?
Yes, lovely. Does he have a press secretary? Does Uncle Torvald have a press secretary?
He does all his own ironing himself. Sometimes he gets a little too much starch, but the cuffs are beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And the collar, see, that's a good job.
Now, tell me, how did he do in the primaries?
Uncle Torvald did wonderful in the primary.
Oh, good.
We're worried, though, that he's going to flunk high school. Oh, he does terrible in algebra. He does terrible in Latin.
What about chemistry?
That's chemistry.
What about it?
He doesn't do so good.
Oh, that's too bad.
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here equal on the Radio Television Network to state my policy. They come to think of what my premium is due. Anyway, I got my whole program set up for Senator of the United States. Nell, strike up the music, and I'll tell the crowd exactly where I stood on the whole doggone mess. Torval for Senator. Torval for Senator. I'll move Disneyland to Pennsylvania Avenue. Besides that, in the Senate, I'll install a barbecue. I'll put an ice cream parlor in the Hall of Justice, too. Torvald for Senator. You know, when I get to Washington, I'll introduce a bill to subsidize Santa Claus and bring back vaudeville. I'll know each crook that comes to town, I'll catch him at his crime. I did 10 years myself, and I can spot him every time. I'll redo the White House in a flowered calico. You know the rocking chair can stay, boys, but the golf club's gotta go. If I don't make much pinger, I don't care about the pay. I'll have it fixed so we can play touch football every day. Torvald for Senator, here I am. Torvald for Senator. You know, I'm not a Republican and I'm not a Democrat. And I never led an army and I never sold a hat. But I'm just what this country needs, a Swede from Everett. Torvald for Senator. You know, I have been openly attacked by my opponents who keep yelling, look at Torvald's record. Look at Torvald's record. They'll go on down and look at it. If it's all right with the parole board, it's all right with me. And if they say, Senator Thorvald, what about these countries that owe us a doggone much money? Well, I'll say, why don't we flip them for double or nothing? Fair enough. You know, for years they have lied to you. And for years they have robbed you. And for years they have cheated you. Now give me a chance. And what's more, I'm going to be the best doggone politician that money can buy. So when you go to the polls, put your confidence in a real confidence man. Thorvald for senator. Thorvald for senator. Thorvald for senator. If you are poor, I'll sympathize with you right off the bat. And if you got too much money, I'm going to fix it so you're flat. And if you're tired of living, I'm going to take care of that. Thorvald for senator. Thorvald for senator. Now don't forget, friend, when you go to the pool, pull down the yaw lever for Thorvald for senator. I'm the man what can do the job for you. Two lutefisks in every pot. This, is that enough?
I'm so nervous about, you know, a piano lesson. I've never given a lesson on the piano for, years. Oh, here she is now. Come in. Come in to the club.
Oh, hello. Well, there you are. You know, I knew that if I didn't warn you, you would still be here. When it's so nice of you to offer to listen to me and help improve on my technique.
I'm happy to do it, Grandma.
Yeah. Well, I tell you, this is going to be a great musical experience for me, too.
And for me, too.
And I've just been practicing like everything so that I could just, you know, do good on my return to the musical world.
One.
Because I'm getting so tired of that switchboard thing where I just plug in and unplug and plug in and unplug, you see.
I suppose that's boring.
So I thought that I would return to the musical world with my big band song.
Oh.
Me and another fella is going to do it.
Oh,
yeah. I'm going to not play too much in the middle.
You're not?
I never did go for middle C too much. I play most of my stuff either on the bottom or on the top.
Oh.
And that way I work both ends against the middle. See?
Yes, I see.
Yeah, and this black keys sort of makes me up pretty good.
Well,
and then there's a whole bunch of white ones that's very confusing, too.
Well, they're all important, though.
I have an idea. When I get really going, I'm going to paint everything gray.
Gray?
That will help. Yeah. And notice that my arpeggios.
Yeah. Oh, I will.
And my credendos.
I'll watch all of those.
And my pianissimos are andante candelabra.
Oh, that's serious.
And stuff. I just live my music.
That's the only way to do it.
And I breathe music.
That's the attitude.
And I hope someday that I could learn to read music. Maybe even play it a little bit. You know, they asked me the other night, I did a little concert work, and they said, can you play Vedon upon the Swanee River?
Yeah.
And I said, well, if it's all the same to you, I'd just as soon get the job right here in Seattle.
Hmm.
The neighbors, I live in a wonderful neighborhood, and the neighbors are so nice.
Are they?
They love to hear me practice. They keep throwing rocks to the window so they can hear me better. Now, yeah, let me add her. Let me add her.
Oh, well, go ahead and play.
I'm going to play this tune for
good.
You now. I want you should know this. It's a very strong melody line.
Ah.
You never heard such a strong melody line as this one is going to be.
That's important, though, Grandpa. Play it strong.
It's a big thank you. Well, what do you think, honestly?
Well, honestly, Grandma, I don't think there's a thing I can do for you, really.
Well, I knew I was good, but I had no idea I was perfect. Hello, world. Here I come.
Oh, so whether to be too much too bad, right? I are Sam Samoto, who are dropping by clubhouse to sing beautiful music. I have my favorite song, which I just love to sing, called I Call My Girlfriend Hinges, because she's something to adore. Which are on the flip side of Show Me a Home Where Buffalo Roam, I Show You Filthy House. All right, we just record this on 12 2-inch records, which we've been using for buttons, selling just like a hotcake. Hope it starts to sell like a record pretty quick. All right, please, to play on the piano with a whole ten of one. Oh, good. Yes, sir, just my baby. No, sir, not a mean lady. Yes, sir, just my baby. Now, up and put your arm, it's a real cool one. Yes, sir, we are decided. No, sir, we are not hiding. Yes, sir, just my baby. Now, yes, indeed, you are exceedingly joyous. By the way, hidey hi, yep. When I'm meeting that preacher, I say, hello, Peppy, me feeling lucky. Just had a little couple seconds. Yes, sir, that my baby. No, sir, not a little baby. Yes, sir, that my baby now. By the way, hidey hi, hi. By the way, hidey hi, yo. When I'm meeting that preacher, I say, hello, Joe, what do you know? What I'm cooking in Tokyo. Yes, sir, just my baby. No, sir, not a mini baby. Yes, sir, just my baby now. Yes, indeed, you're a real cute chick. Sayonara. Banzai. You know, like? Oh, you know, like music? Oh, you know, like my music? Oh, so sorry, please. So sorry, no, like music? Oh, too bad. The wrong accent. I mean, oh, I'm changing cars.
Well, here I am. I forgot which accent went with who. Anyways, I wait till I remind myself who I am. I are the Swedish answer man, who is no Saul and see Saul, and can't keep my big mouth shut about any of it. And here comes in the question to me from Della Catesan of Sweet Pickle, Pennsylvania. She says, can you tell me who wrote The Prisoner of Zenda? Well, nobody wrote The Prisoner of Zenda. He wasn't allowed to receive mail while he was in prison. I threw that in for Al. Here comes one in from Hank Kerchief of Runny Nose, Nebraska. He says, I'm planning to move to the state of Washington. What product is raised most in the state of Washington? Umbrellas is the one that we raise the most on. All right, we're having a warming trend. Here comes one from Tony Permanent of Curly Locks, Louisiana. The other day I was asked to use the word paradox in a sentence. Can you help me to use the word paradox in a sentence? I certainly may. Here's a sentence. On our farm we had 4 chickens, 6 geese, and a paradox. Next question. Here we come in from Von Butches. Kurt Unheit. Never heard of him. Of Snasola, Sweden. If joy is the opposite of sorrow, what is the opposite of woe? The opposite of woe is giddy up. And there we go. All right. Here comes in Von from Al R.G. of Hay Fever, Vermont. If you take a potato and divide it into 2 parts, and then you take each part and divide it into 4 parts, and all of those parts, and you divide all those parts into 4 parts, how many parts would you have? I mean, what would you have? You would have potato salad is what you would have. Ugh. Well, you can't win them all. Here comes one in from Stark Realism of You Said It, Connecticut. Stark wants to know, what did the ugly duckling turn into? Well, I'm happy to announce that the ugly duckling turned into an ugly duck. On the contrary to what you may have heard in the books.
Say, here's a peppy good tune on a beautiful day like this, huh? I love the sunshine of your smile. I love the laughter in your eyes. Every dream I dream is you. You are the one I idolize. Nobody thrills me like you do. You turn the gray skies into blue. And you always make my life worthwhile with the sunshine of your smile. The laughter in your eyes. Every dream I dream is you. You are the one I idolize. Nobody thrills me like you do. You turn the gray skies into blue. And you always make my life worthwhile with the sunshine of your smile. Yes, the sunshine of your smile.
Well, I have a little something here all cut up and ready to eat. I'm going to try my little experiment again today. You know, no more sleeps. And she snores, and she sleeps, and she takes it easy. But if something real good comes along, like a Hostess Twinkie, and if I should happen to just put that under her nose where she can get a whiff of that delicious aroma that the Hostess Twinkie gives off, you know, that delicious brown sponge cake, and then that yummy center that it has, if she gets a whiff of that, she sort of comes to. Would you like, shall we experiment? I shall try it now. Here we go. Here we go. How do you like that, Mole? You see, there's what I was telling you about. There's that cream center that's so good. Yeah. Doesn't it taste out of this world? Well, that's what Hostess Twinkies are. They're just simply, they're so good that they're just out of this world. Now you're eating a little bit of the cream center there. And the whole thing is that delicious sponge cake. Well, this whole section of the clubhouse is brought to you by the Hostess people, Mo. And they're the people that leave these wonderful Hostess Twinkies down here every day so that you and I can eat all these good things. Isn't that right, Mo? Well, I tell you, we're very proud and happy to be associated with the Hostess people so that we can tell all the gang about going to their favorite grocery store and checking on it at the cake counter. So, gang, get plenty of Hostess Twinkies, won't you? I know that you like them just like Nomo and I do here in the clubhouse. Hostess Twinkies are out of this world, aren't they? Could you give a little speak? Not a sneeze, a speak. Oh, good girl. All right, well, we'll give you a little more Hostess Twinkie here in a minute. And now,
For our next exercise, girls, get the great, big, heavy, strong chair. And this next exercise is to build the back muscles. And it's not so bad for your character either. Have you got a chair there, Saturn? Oh, yeah, Muscatel, excuse me. Oh, she's new here. All right, here is how we do this wonderful exercise. Throw your right leg into the air as you swing the upper half of your body to the left while reversing your head in the right turn and relaxing the heel muscles. You raise your left foot 2 feet from the ground and twist the calf at a 20-degree angle, increasing the stomach muscles with an outward motion. Have you got that? All right, here we go. You got the chair there, Saturn. All right, here, I mean Burgundy. No, Muscatel. Excuse me. All right, here we go now, Axel. Spin the music. Good, Axel. There it is, the good old Axel. All right, you ready there, Burgundy, Muscatel? Let her rip. 1, 2, 3. For heavenly days. While we're waiting for Muscatel to compose herself here for the next exercise, we're going to have a word from our sponsor, Flab Off. Flab Off, the instant weight remover. Oh, you'll just see the weight drop off in buckets, girls, with Flab Off. Say, fellas, are you tired of living with a slightly overweight wife of 285 pounds? Well, I can sympathize with you. But now with instant Flab Off, it just will drop off instantly. Yes, sir, and you'll go from 5'7", weighing 285 pounds, to 6'9", weighing 285 pounds. The only trouble with Flab Off is that it doesn't last too long. It has an instant effect, and then it's all gone. So, girls, you've got to keep nipping all day. Take another slug there and show them how it works. Look at there, that thin and svelte, and you just lose it all in a moment. And then you got to be careful, because just almost immediately, you're right back to your old fat, flabby self again. Now, if you do like this product, Flab Off, girls, don't see your doctor or your druggist. No. Meet me down at First and Yesler on Saturday night. Oh, see what I say? It doesn't last long. But meet me down on First and Yesler after midnight on Saturday, and I'll slip you a couple of quarts, huh?
Sleigh bells ring and I'm listening, but I'm turning and twisting, 'cause I'm itching up here and I'm scratching down there. I'm walking in my winter underwear. Now the front is all battered and the back is all tattered, but when I'm cold to the core, I crawl through the trap door and up into my winter underwear. Well, I don't care if it rains or snows or freezes, I am so warm I just don't give a hoot. I put on all the stockings I can poke it, then I wear 2 pair of trousers with my suit. But when I start to perspire, yeah, then it sets me on fire, 'cause I'm itching up here and I'm scratching down there, I'm walking in my winter underwear. The winter snow is white and glistening, but I'm turning and twisting. I got to scratch a little here, I got to scratch a little there, I'm walking in my winter underwear.
I put my bathing suit away in mothballs, and now I got to dock the snowballs. When I can't scratch my back, I throw myself on a vac, I'm walking in my winter underwear.
For rain and snow and ice, I do not worry, then winter come, I do not give a hoot.
my coat and hat and ear must keep me cozy, and that air to pair of trousers fit my suit.
But then it comes to other clothing,
well, the thing that I am loathing,
it's when my face turns blue
and contortions I go through. I'm walking in my winter underwear, there from Sears Roll Off. Walking in my winter underwear.
You're just in time to sing the theme song, and here we go. Are you ready? Are you ready, Herm? Are you ready, Nomo? Oh, are you ready? Well, for are you here today, too?
Yes, I'm ready.
Oh, for goodness sake. Here we go. All together now. Zero docus, mooch or crocus, hallabaloo's above. That's a secret password that we use down at the club. And zero docus, mooch or crocus, hallabaloo's a fan, means now you are a member of King's TV Club with Stan and Herman. And oh, we're gonna have a dandy time today. And oh, let me see. Let's have a peppy song. It's such a nice day, and all. Would you like to join us and sing? We should all be enjoying ourselves on a wonderful day like this.
Yeah,
is that
that's
a
thing.
Song plug or?
Well, how about one? Enjoy yourself, Carter? What do you think?
All right.
Enjoy yourself. It's later than you think. Enjoy yourself. While you're still in the pink, the years go by as quickly as a wink. Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think.
Now you work and work for years and years, you're always on the go. You never take a minute off, too busy making dough. Someday you say you'll have some fun when you're a millionaire. Just think of all the fun you'll have in your old rocking chair. Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think. Enjoy yourself while you're still in the pink. The years go by as quickly as a wink. Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think.
That's pretty good there, enjoying yourself in the old rocking chair, like you said there.
Yeah, I thought you were going to say that.
Well, I couldn't get into the rocking chair in time. I appreciate you getting me out of the bind there.
Oh, well, that's all right, old town. Okay. Well, this is the section of the, is there an animal in there with you two? This is zoo day, but what? What are you playing a joke on me, old timer? Let's see. Come out here with that again.
Oh, there.
What in the world are you doing?
Hey, Mr. Barber.
What is it?
This is the worm that turned.
Oh, is that the worm that turned?
Yep. Tell well, me, this is zoo day?
Yep, this is zoo day.
Zoo, zoo.
Oh, corny. Here comes, shut your door, old timer. I want to surprise you with this animal from the zoo today. Shut your door.
Yeah, just a minute.
Okay, here it comes. It's just a cute little hamster. I think you're going to like
that
it.
Hamster, Mr. Barnburg?
Here it is. Oh, Mo, now don't get
Neil,
it's a cute little animal. How are you, Nick?
Fine,
sir. Isn't that a cute little hamster, Nick?
Oh, yes.
Don't you think the old-timer would like to have that visit him in the closet?
He might.
What is... Oh, for goodness sakes. How old is this little hamster here?
Oh, pretty close to 5 years old.
5 years old? How much bigger will this little hamster get?
Well, maybe a little over twice the size it is now. Maybe three.
What does this hamster eat now?
Meat.
Oh, it eats meat, old-timer.
The hamster, I thought they ate green there.
Well, I don't know. This is a different kind of hamster, I guess. It's not a vegetarian, anyway. Don't you like the little lamb, Herman? Oh, you do like the little... Well, good. We all have to be friendly here in the clubhouse. Isn't this the cutest little lamb here? How old is this little lamb?
Just 2 weeks today.
Well, 2 weeks today. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, little lambie. Happy birthday to you. Well, we'd love to see that. Yeah, old Herm wants to see it too. There, Herm, just look at the picture. Don't break it now. Just look at the pictures, Herman. Herman wants to see the book. There, see? There's some of your friends out there at Woodland Park, you see? Well, this is a book that they have out at Woodland Park called Who's Who at the Zoo. And on page number one here is a picture of, where's that pic?
Where's that picture of that fella that I'm looking? And here's the old-timer's family right here on page number 12, right there. There's his mother and father. Or is that your nephew?
Yes, my nephew's out there.
There's your nephew out there. And look who this fella is. That's Nick right here from the zoo. And here's baby's first outing, little lamb. And here's the old-timer.
Could I see my picture there?
Well, I'll show it to you later.
Yeah, I'll show it. Good?
Oh, no, here's the old-timer.
Oh, it's nice.
What did you do to your nose that week, old-timer?
Well, I don't know. That's probably the week it was so cold there.
Well, it looks a little frozen up there on top. And your eyes, you better check your eyes. You may need glasses. You got a glassy stare in your eyes there.
Yeah.
Could I pick up one of you?
Okay.
You think it'd be all right? Oh, just don't. I won't hurt you. We want to get you up here so that the gang out there can get a good little look at you. Tiny little baby chick.
Mole, look at here, Mole. Now be careful of him, though. Be real careful. That's a little tiny baby duck, you see. Isn't that a cute little thing? Say, isn't it lucky that it rained last night?
Oh, it sure is.
And that we got all this water here? How old are these ducks?
These are about a week old now.
Can they swim? Look at it. It's too young to be frightened, even. Look at there, Mole. It likes you. Do they swim when they're a week old?
Oh, yes.
Just think, just a week ago they were in the egg, gang. Now look at them. They're just full of vim and vigor here. You're getting acquainted, aren't you? Do you have these skunks deodorized?
This one isn't yet. But it doesn't matter for another few weeks yet.
Uh-huh. But the ones at the park, I mean?
Oh, the big ones are all descented, yes.
Now, they make nice pets, I've heard.
Yes, a little lazy.
Are they lazy? Well, I'm used to lazy pets, I'll tell you that. I've got the laziest I get. I bet I have something that'll beat this, don't you think, Nick?
Oh, yes.
But when they grow up, do they still stay gentle, or...?
Some of them do. They don't make as good a pet as a dog or a cat.
Mm-hmm.
They're an unusual pet is about all.
Remember my speeding aboard. She come from Wisconsin in the Model T Ford. With a barrel of herring and a bucket of cheese. You could tell she was coming by sniffing the breeze. Sing doodle-dee-doodle-dee-roodie-toot-toot. Roodle-dee-doodle-dee-roodie-toot-toot. With a barrel of herring and a bucket of cheese. You could tell she was coming by sniffing the breeze.
Reach Fargo, Ingeborg, she pooped out. She was real gone of that, there was no doubt. So we waved the herring right under her nose. One whiff of that herring and oop, she arose.
Sing roodle-dee-doodle-dee-ring-a-ding-ding. Roodle-dee-doodle-dee-ring-a-ding-ding. So we waved the herring right under her nose. One whiff of that herring and oop, she arose.
By the first day of May, we had reached Disneyland. You looked at me and said, isn't it grand? I said, yeah, terrific, but not quite my dish. And before I die, I have one final wish.
Sing roodle-dee-doodle-dee-rassum-a-tass. Roodle-dee-doodle-dee-rassum-a-tass.
I said, yeah, terrific, but not quite my dish. And before I die, I have one final wish. I've seen everything in this world you can see, except for the one most important to me. This is the land of honey and milk, but I come from Wisconsin to see Lawrence Welk.
Sing one and a two and a wonderful, wonderful. One and a two and a wonderful, wonderful.
This is the land of honey and milk, but I come from Wisconsin to see Lawrence Welk.
I have one of Uncle Torvald's good numbers here. I want to sing for you before we have our first cartoon, which is the 500 Hats of Bartholomew Cubbins. And here's one of Uncle Torvald's favorite hats, and here's one of his favorite new songs. Not the way Como sings it. Different. Hat-trick.
to pickle herring, put it in the barrel, never let it get away. Catch a pickle herring, put it in the barrel, save it for a rainy day. As you know, we may get in a recession, and you lose your job. But if you've got some pickle herring handy, you'll find that things will turn out dandy. Catch a pickle herring, put it in the barrel, no matter what your friends may say. Catch a pickle herring, put it in a barrel, watch the neighbors move away. Some people think that Limburger cheese is really a fright, but wait till you smell pickle herring on a hot and sultry summer night. Yeah, it is a fright. Holy mackerel. Catch a pickle herring, put it in a barrel, though it takes your breath away. Catch a pickle herring, put it in a barrel, serve it on a silver tray. And then you know, whenever you get hungry, here's what you do. Get some pickle herring if you're able, eat it quick before it stains the table. Catch a pickle herring, put it in a barrel, save it for a rainy day. And never, never, ever let it get away.
Well, that's a new bird. It'll never get popular.
Well, sure of that, aren't we, gang? But we have fun wrecking them, don't we?
So you be sure and join us every day, of course, at 3:30. And now and then, this friend over here drops in, and we live it up a little with musical singing and things like that.
Yeah. Yeah, now what say, Mr. Barber?
Wonderful cartoons.
And wonderful, wonderful, yes.
Turn off the bubble machine.
Yes.
And here, Nomo and Miss Mo are always full of life here at the clubhouse. You know that, and just zippity-doo-dah, raring to go. Look at them there, so
yes.
Excited about the program and the fun that they have down here.
You know that wonderful,
wake up,
wonderful.
Look excited. Girls, look, wake up. That's it. Look excited.
Mr.
That's
Barnberg.
It. Now you wake up, Miss Mo. Look, well, it's too late to be excited now. Go back to sleep, Mo. We'll see you tomorrow, gang, at the same time. Singer.
Singer. Here we go.
Zero dash and smooch across and hallabaloo above. That's the secret password that we use out in the club. Zero dash and smooch across and hallabaloo's a plan. Because now you are a member of King Stevie Club with Stan.
Go, Herm, go. That's it, Herm.